Hey everybody, and welcome back to TechZulu Live here at New Media Expo in Las Vegas. Oh, Las Vegas, how we love thee. I am sitting here now with writer-director Sandra Payne, who I've never met in person, but I know online very well, so we're meeting in real life.
It's so exciting, yay!
How are you? I'm great, you know, it's we're just talking before we jumped on camera. It's so amazing to get to know people the way that we do online. I mean, I have a connection with someone like you, even though we haven't done this before. So the power of the web, let's start there.
It's, you know, it really is a fantastic thing that I have made a lot of friends on, especially via Twitter. Yeah. The people, you know, with Facebook, it's 6 degrees of separation. You kind of know people and have friends who know people. But on Twitter, it can be absolutely someone random, and I have made real true friendships from people that I would have never had the opportunity to meet prior to social media.
I have a really cool story I can share really fast as it relates to friendships and Twitter. A very good friend of mine that I grew up with back home, he needed to raise some money for kind of an urgent situation. I won't go into what, but an urgent situation for a family member. And he turned to Twitter to do it. And he just posted a message, kind of a plea on Twitter that was like, hey guys, could everyone just pitch in a couple of bucks? Here's the PayPal account. This is really important. This is sort of a dire situation. He raised a good sum of money just through friends on Twitter, many, many, many of which he's never met in real life, to help with this family situation over the holidays. And that just, oh, that warmed my heart, you know, just thinking these are real friendships, whether or not you've met someone in real life.
It's absolutely true. I can share a similar story to that. My cat is on Twitter, and it makes me sound crazy, but
Wait. I need the Twitter handle. What is Kitty Cat's Twitter handle?
It's Tuffy Cat. So Tuffy Cat is has made quite a lot of friends in the animal kingdom, and
and otherwise.
Yes. And in fact, Minute Maid named him as one of the best Twitter animals that you should know about.
Oh my God.
But he has 10,000 followers on Twitter. And
the cat.
Yes. But what's really cool about the animal accounts on Twitter is that they also raise money to help animals. And there's a dog who just passed away, sadly, but his name was Frugal Dougal, and he started the hashtag Paw Potty on Twitter, and he raised like thousands, $50,000 for animal charities around the world.
Yeah, so there's so much social good going on. So people, I think earlier on with Facebook and Twitter, you know, we always go back to those two examples, even though there are many, many more now.
Yes.
But even starting with those, it was sort of noisy and people were trying to figure out what it was at first. And then it's really turned into this machine for organizing and motivating your tribe, so to speak. Would
you
agree with that?
That's a great way to put it. I love that. Exactly. It is motivating to be a member of a tribe and have someone say, let's do this.
Yeah.
And be like, well yeah, that's my tribe. I'm going to do that.
Yeah.
And also sharing information. Those would be the two things.
Sure.
But being able to make change for social good via social media is absolutely part of what is beneficial about it.
Now, all these tools that we have, how have they helped you as a writer and director? I mean, how have you dabbled? Which tools are you playing with? And how does that sort of shape your work?
Well, that is an awesome question, because as a web series creator, without social media, there's no doubt that it would be a lot harder road to be able to find your fans and be able to go out there and put content out there. And we have an entirely new world now where it's more important as a creator to make sure that you build your personal brand and find your fans and bring them with you from project to project, because it's not, the old paradigms are totally gone.
Yeah.
And we have to be responsible for our own audience and making sure that we talk with them, engage with them, and make content that serves them.
It's sort of taking a page out of the playbook of the gaming industry, because if you look at all sorts of online games, they build these rabid fan bases and then they just roll out new games to that fan base that's going to suit them. So it's like there's this built-in audience ready and waiting, you know, chomping at the bit for the next game to come out. Similar to the way that we're approaching web series now.
And that would be the ideal way as a web series creator, to be able to work, is have it on the gaming model and make sure that I create content that brings in super fans. And so far, even though I've made 90 episodes of web series in the last few years.
Already 90 episodes.
Indeed. And one of them, The Web Files, was now retired, but won the International Academy of Web Television Award for 2012 for Best Hosted Taped Web Series. Yeah. And we made 51 episodes of that, one a week for a year. And then I have a romantic comedy called Life with Cat and McKay that I'm going to do second season of.
Okay.
And also a sketch comedy one called Ask Graham. And then I'm going to make more. But I think the more I'm on, the more I create web series, the more I learn about how to create things that will engage the fans that I have.
Yeah. What are some of the ways that you're testing your audience in terms of storytelling, in terms of feedback, engagement, maybe even offline? I mean, what are some of the things that you're using and really playing around with in that department?
Well, I think for me, it's more of an aggregate knowledge thing, because after making this many web series, I kind of have taken all that information of how do they do and who's watching and where do they come from, and all that is funneling into creating another series this year that will hopefully get to be bigger than what I've made in the past. And it's because what I've learned is, okay, there's certain genres that do better online.
Like what?
Sci-fi. Which is what I'm going to do.
Nice. This is making Amanda very happy.
Excellent, Amanda. And
I'm going to be bugging you off camera.
Excellent. I love hearing that. So, you know, when you make sci-fi, there's a fan base online that's, you know, they're tech smart. They get it. Yeah. And they're going to find you. And they like that level of creativity that, as a writer, we can bring. And so it's fun and exciting. But, yeah, if you're like romantic comedy, my first one, maybe not exactly the best genre.
Yeah. What about timing? You know, that everything ranges wildly from 30 seconds to 5 minutes to 20 minutes to an hour. Like, what time span has worked with your audience?
I'm super excited to report that we have more time online now. Okay. Because it used to be, like, The Web Files is about an 8 minute per episode show. And that was really pushing it. Mm-hmm. But now I see so many things that are like 15 minutes and stuff.
Yeah.
And people that like content, they want to immerse themselves.
Right.
And so if you kick them out in 2 minutes, they're like, wait, what? Yeah.
No, wait, stop. But Sandra's doing something with sci-fi. No, wait.
Exactly. So I feel like we have a lot more leeway now. And I also, people are more able to realize, oh, they can watch a whole network television show online. So if they can do that, they can surely watch a web series that's 15 minutes or 20 or 30, maybe.
Yeah.
So it can all happen now.
Wow. In terms of the people that are in this space creating the content, what does that type of person look like? How many, who is creating web series content these days?
What's so fun about that is that it's everybody. So all colors, all races, all genders, all...
Do you have to be in New York or LA to create a web series?
Absolutely not. Without a doubt.
Okay.
This is, you have carte blanche to make what you want to make, create what you want to create, and no matter where you live, you have the opportunity to do it. There are things that you can do that will make it better for you, which is, one, join the IWTV, because we are a very smart group of people.
And it's exploded. It's turned into a mafia. I thought I was part of a mafia with Emerson. You know, Emerson College, Emerson Mafia. It's very real and it exists. But I think the IAWTV is starting to rival our mafia.
You should join us. If you have any interest in being on the web and web TV, being a member of IAWTV is pretty critical, I think.
Cool. Well, great shout out to that, and I'm assuming you will be there tonight for the award show.
I'll be there tonight. I look forward to it.
Great.
So I'll see you later.
Absolutely. And what for those who want to follow you, what is your Twitter handle?
SP Wright.
SP Wright. Sandra, right over here.
Purstock TV is my other Twitter. Purstock TV is more for the web.
Sure.
SP Wright is more about being a writer.
Yep. Well, so glad to finally meet you in person, Sandra, and I will be tweeting out at you later this evening just to say hello and to catch up.
Thank you so much, Amanda. I really appreciate it.
See you soon, and make sure, she's right, make sure that you sign up for IAWTV. Join, become a member. It will help you.
Definitely.